I made a room for this prime minister.
He's cleaning up your mess, isn't he?
No, no.
How do you sleep at night?
I have asked an apology to my people. Labeling me dictator is wrong.
Ethiopia has come a long way in a short time. There's a new peace deal with Eritrea and a new prime minister, apparently determined to bring accountability for the human rights abuses of the past. My guest this week here in Brussels is his predecessor, Hailemariam Desalegn, who denied for many years that human rights violations had taken place and whose government locked up many thousands of political prisoners. Has he no shame for the torture that was perpetrated and the lives that were ruined during his time in office? Hailemariam Desalegn, welcome to Conflict Zone.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Ethiopia has a new prime minister now, Abiy Ahmed, who took over after you resigned last year. He's now received a Nobel Peace Prize, basically for undoing many of the evils of your government and doing what you couldn't do within 100 days. Don't you feel something of a failure when you look at what he's done?
Not at all, because I have done my share to bring this change to happen. And Prime Minister Abiy has not come from a blue moon. It has come from the party which I was residing.
Yeah, but he's begun correcting the massive human rights abuses which were a prominent feature of your time in office.
Actually, my party which started the reform process. And we said the process should be a deep renewal to the country, basically, but also to the party itself. So I think that is a process which yielded Prime Minister Abiy as Prime Minister. So he continued with the process, the reform agenda that my party and his party.
Well, the Nobel Committee cited his achievements as lifting the country's state of emergency, granting amnesty to thousands of political prisoners. For years, you always denied there were any. Scrapping media censorship, legalizing outlawed opposition groups, dismissing military and civilian leaders suspected of corruption. All the things that you failed to do when you were in office.
By the way, do you know that 95% of the prisoners have been released during my office time? Before I left office and before I resigned. So I think what Abiy did was the remaining 5%, which has to be released. So the decision was a decision of the party, and I took that action before I resigned.
How many did you release?
Almost all.
How many? How many?
More than 3,000 or so.
Yeah, but there were many more than 3,000 in jail.
Yeah, but it's only young people who recently been arrested, been released. But the main political figures which has been arrested, been released during my term before I resigned.
In May this year, the Attorney General filed criminal charges against your former intelligence chief, Getachew Assefa, alleging human rights abuses and corruption. He's gone missing now. Do you know where he went?
I don't know. I am not in office now. I have no information.
20 other people were charged with him. He had served until June 2018. He had served you as Prime Minister, who were denying that any human rights abuses were being committed.
I think you lack information. You lack evidence. It is my government and my party who admitted that there has been a human rights abuse.
You never admitted. You sat year after year in interviews saying, nobody's being mistreated, we have no political prisoners. One after the other, you gave interviews sitting smiling across at the interviewer saying, no, everything's fine here, you know, everybody's fine.
You have to understand the way how our party operate.
No, I'm understanding the way you operate, which is you lied
first.
Your head off.
Let me finish first. If that's the case, then you know that we have historical issues that we have to understand. That in the first place, this is a party far left. And you know, as in a Deutsche Welle, when there is a communist mentality and when there is a Marxist mentality, there is a centralism where You don't utter a word after your party decides on issues, even though you have differences in as a minority.
You just toe the line, whatever it is, because you're too cowardly to say anything about what's really going on? Is that your excuse?
That's also misplacing. And the whole thing is that we believed in our party and the government that we need to reform our system. We need to bring about changes, and we need to democratize our country, and because that's a country with a number of interests, and there is an introduction of ethnic mobilized politics, which is very dangerous, and therefore we have decided that we need to go further and deeply in reforming our country.
Which was something you didn't do.
I did.
If you had done that, Prime Minister, when he came in, Prime Minister Abiy, wouldn't have had to condemn police brutality, pledge to rein in the security services, tackle what he called economic mismanagement, corruption, and rights abuses. All of this stemming from your time in office.
This is also misplacing, because Prime Minister Abiy has not come from a blue moon.
He has been. Doesn't matter where he came from.
He was there with us.
He's cleaning up your mess, isn't he?
No. It's not. He's not cleaning up his messes.
He's cleaning up your mess. He's cleaning up the mess you left behind.
No, I think this is also misplacing. And I always say that, you know, correctly, this is our party's admission of our collective mistake. And then we has put in place properly.
He's done the things that you failed to do. By November last year, dozens of intelligence officers and high-level officials had been arrested, including people from the military-run Metals and Engineering Corporation, METEC, on charges of corruption and human rights abuses. You never put those charges to these people.
That is the study which I introduced.
No, you didn't.
He finished.
You didn't.
I did it.
November last year, you weren't in office.
I did it. You don't have any evidence. I did it. I launched the studies, and in completion of that studies, then action has been taken.
The Attorney General said 63 people had been arrested that month, November last year, 27 for corruption, 36 on charges of human rights violation. That included the former head of METEC, Kinfe Dagnew, a brigadier general, over whom you did nothing. You did nothing about these people.
I made that study. You lack evidence. I launched the study. I assigned a group of people who studied it.
It's not about a study. It's charging people with human rights. You didn't charge them, and you didn't point to the corruption.
You charge people after you study, after concrete evidence.
You have a criminal investigation.
That investigation has been launched by my time.
Local media said huge sums of money were missing from this company, METEC. Where did it go?
Let the court decide on it.
As Prime Minister, you were supposed to look after the public purse.
I did.
The military was supposed to follow your orders, and you seem to have failed spectacularly to make them do that. Don't you feel any remorse at the crimes you allowed to take place while you were Prime Minister?
No, I think I have resigned because I was not able to, you know, change dramatically whatever has to come.
You were too weak.
Ineffectual. Actually, I have my own strengths and I have my own weaknesses. And you have to not to look into only the weaknesses, but you have to also see the strengths this country has gone. And you know that my country has been visited during my tenure by 6 of the 7 G7 leaders, and they all announced that this country has been working very hard, a double-digit growth, and economic achievements, where we have extricated our people out of poverty. The only country which has achieved 7 out of the 8 MDGs and awarded by the United Nations by my time. So I think you have to see all those positive things we have achieved.
Last November, Mr. Hailemariam, the Attorney General, Berhanu Tsigaye, said investigators had uncovered serious abuses by security services at secret prisons in the capital and elsewhere. Do you know what your security officers were doing in those secret prisons?
I don't know those things.
Why didn't you know? Did you ever ask? Did you ever visit?
How can I do if your intelligence doesn't give you information? How can you know?
There were plenty of foreign reports that torture was going on, which you denied,
and
you
no. did.
And now you're telling me you didn't know what was going on.
No, I didn't.
So
know
your
exactly
denials were false. Your denials were just pro forma denials.
No, not at all.
The way you denied everything when you were in office.
No, not at all.
You did. You sat there denying everything. You didn't know what was going on in these prisons. You didn't ask. You weren't interested.
What I know is officially we know some of the abuses, and I have taken in my time some of the actions to correct those things. But I didn't know that there are informal prisons which has been there.
The Attorney General said there are people that have been blinded and held in darkness for long periods of time. Others have been left infertile because of blows to their genitals. There are some that had limbs broken. Women have been subjected to gang rape, and men have been sodomized. All this happened under your rule. So I ask you, aren't you ashamed that this was going on under your rule?
No, I am ashamed. You're not ashamed. I am ashamed that this happened, but I didn't know those things, and if I knew those things, I would have corrected them. Because this is a very secret things happened.
Well, it didn't take long for this Prime Minister to find out what was going on. So obviously he was looking in the right place, and you did nothing.
You
didn't want to look, did you?
I made a room for this Prime Minister to act. I struggled very hard to bring him to power. And I did everything.
You lost control. That's why you gave up. You lost control, and the party lost faith in you. That's why you gave up.
No, I think you can say that. But
and you were struggling to control
that's
unrest
the
in the country, but
that's
you were failing to do that
I
as well.
I did it myself. I did it intentionally because I wanted to see that this change should come. So I think this is genuinely what has happened, and I did my best in paving a way for this to happen. So I think that has to be clearly recorded, and I did it.
I think it'd be clearly regarded when women in your prisons during your term in office were being subjected to gang rape and men to sodomization. Now that you know this, even if you say you didn't know it at the time, where's your apology to the victims?
I think I have already apologized when I resigned, because that's a system which was operating
have you
under
met,
me.
Have you met the victims and apologized personally to them?
If there is a need be, I will.
You haven't done so, have you?
I haven't get those chance, and I will. We have a reconciliation and truth and a reconciliation commission established, and that process is going on.
How do you sleep at night knowing that this was going on in your torture centers, carried out by your officials while you were Prime Minister? How do you sleep at night?
If I knew, then I say to you that I was there to correct everything in my disposal if I knew it, but I didn't know that.
You're said to be a religious man from a family of Pentecostals. Is that right?
That's true.
How does gang rape and sodomization fit in with your religious values?
No, I didn't know. I said, if I knew, it doesn't fit in my values.
But you went on denying it in every interview. That's the report I have.
No,
despite the reports coming in from human rights groups all over the world, which you just rubbished. You said, that's not true, they're outsiders, they're our enemies, don't listen to them. Everything is fine, you said.
I think I have never said everything is fine.
You said there was no mistreatment. No mistreatment going on.
There is a problem, but I was saying that my report is that it's not to the extent what has been said. That's what I said. But in any case, I have a report which I was giving to the public, which was the case.
Let's take another detention center, Jijiga Central Prison, otherwise known as Jail Ogaden, a regional detention center in the east of the country, administered in part by your special police. It was closed in August last year. Do you know what was going on there as well?
No, I don't know.
Why not? You knew the prison existed.
You had no curiosity.
You had no curiosity, Mr. Hailemariam. You didn't want to know what was going on in your jails,
did
you?
No, it's not the case. The regional governments have their own rights, And I think the whole thing is I did my work according to the reports I get from my intelligence and from my sources, and therefore that's what was the case.
People reported, there were many of the former prisoners who said they saw people dying in their cells after being tortured by officials in this Ogaden jail, as it was called. What should happen to the officials who carried out this torture?
I mean,
what should happen to them?
They're imprisoned.
That's it?
Yeah.
Just prison sentences. And what should happen to you for turning a blind eye to it?
That depends on this legal system of the country. You know, I resigned simply because to take all the responsibilities.
But what is extraordinary is that with all the abuses that were carried out while you were Prime Minister, you accepted from the new Prime Minister the nation's highest award for service without even blushing, without any embarrassment whatsoever. Now that you know what was going on while you were Prime Minister, why didn't you give back that award?
Why should I? Because I have a number of positive things I have done
because
to my
failed
country.
To take control.
No, this is one part of it.
And that's it's not, a huge
that
part.
Doesn't, that
it's
doesn't
a huge torture is a huge
whatever
part.
I work within my country. That doesn't explain. That's not the only thing. You know, I have done many good things. There are issues in the system which are a failure, which I initiated to reform and deepen that reform because I understood that before my resignation, I understood that there are something going wrong. Therefore, I initiated this reform, and then I have released 95% of those.
You were in office for 6 years, and this new prime minister has come in and done more for human rights than you did in all the time you were there.
It is because I paved the way for him.
Really? The U.S. State Department in 2016 published a catalogue of the human rights abuses taking place under your rule, which of course you denied, but they're now known to be true. Arbitrary killings, disappearances, torture, harsh and life-threatening prison conditions, detention without charge.
You can enumerate whatever you want, but
it's what they said. But yeah. How can you say that you didn't know what was going on when all these reports were out there pointing to what was going on?
Yes, whenever I knew that there are things going wrong, I initiated the reform, and a serious reform and deep reform, and that's the result where the Prime Minister has come as into power.
You said when you resigned that you wanted to be part of the solution in Ethiopia. How can you be part of the solution when you are so much part of the problem?
You know, I become part of the solution because there is a problem.
You created the atmosphere, the permissive atmosphere in which your security officials believed they could torture, that it was all right to torture, go on torturing, disappearing people,
no,
extrajudicial execution.
That's not there.
You created the atmosphere in which that was possible.
No, I didn't create the atmosphere.
So what qualifies
our legal
you?
And the constitutional system has been established, then anyone who's involved within it could be accounted for. But I didn't create this conducive environment for them. It is a deep system which I was not able to look into because of my background and because of my, you know, I am outsider coming into the deep system, so I couldn't see that.
When Mr. Abiy came into power, he couldn't wait to condemn the legacy of your government and draw a line under your time in office, could he? April last year, he said that government, your government, had sanctioned torture of its prisoners and said it had been guilty of state terrorism. He said in Parliament, does the Constitution say anyone who was sentenced by a court can be tortured, put in a dark room?
That's true.
It doesn't.
That's true. That government was his as well, not only mine.
You were the Prime Minister.
I was the Prime Minister, but
he
was there also.
The buck stopped
with
you.
Yeah, we collectively decided to reform, including himself.
The ultimate responsibility lay with you.
With
you.
Yeah, it is. Yes. It is.
Why do you try and get out of it? Why do you try and get out of it?
That's why I initiated the reform. That's why I initiated the, you know, 1 year taken reform.
You initiated reform. You blocked every attempt by the United Nations Special Rapporteur, the UN Human.
It should come from us.
Every attempt.
It should come. You know, so all the reforms should come from us.
And the only reason you blocked, the only reason you blocked them from investigating was because you didn't want them to find out what was going on.
I did, and I initiated the reform before my resignation a year ago. And that reform is what resulted Prime Minister Abiy to come to power.
Hundreds of people were killed.
To bring him to power.
Hundreds of people were killed under your regime, and you refused to have an independent investigation led by the UN's chief human rights official.
If you ask the killings, the last 1.5 years, the number of killings surpassed in 6 years what happened in my time. If you ask for killings, look, that is not the case. So the whole thing is, you know, I initiated this reform and a year ago before my resignation, and I paved the way for the new system.
You let some people come in. You say you initiated the reform. You created a regime where people were tortured and disappeared and had their rights taken away from them consistently. Tens of thousands of people, and you denied it time and time again.
I have asked an apology to my people that the regime has some abuses of, you know, human rights and the deficit in democracy, and that has happened. I still feel that I'm sorry for that, but I initiated for the change to come.
That's not much of an apology, is it? That really isn't. That's a half-hearted apology.
No, it is not.
And
I would have not resigned. You know, I could have taken it to the last, as many leaders.
You couldn't. The party didn't want you to stay. You lost the faith of the party.
No, I haven't lost the security forces. I haven't lost the army.
They're all being arrested. They're being arrested. They should have been. They should have been investigated under your time, and they weren't.
If I want to continue as dictators, you know, I could have used everything up to the last of my breath.
So you always claim dictatorship.
You always
claimed democracy took time. You always said this is a fledgling democracy. It takes time.
Exactly.
This is what every dictator says when they don't want to give up power.
In Europe, you yourself in Europe, you passed through a number of civil wars before you came
to
the democracy.
This is what every dictator says. It's not time.
No,
the people aren't ready. You can't hurry these things.
It's not one day show. Even Europe, United States, everywhere in the Western countries, your democracy has taken time. And it has not come in one shot, in one day, in 1 week, in 1 year. It has taken years to mature. That is true. And that will continue. Democracy is building democratic culture.
Yeah, and you did everything to slow it down. Mr. Hailemariam, you've never shied away from associations or friendships, either with indicted or convicted war criminals, have you? Do they hold some special fascination for you, these people?
Which ones?
Like Mr. al-Bashir, the former president of Sudan. In August, you posted a controversial picture on Facebook of you smiling next to Ethiopia's exiled Marxist leader Mengistu Haile Mariam. And then you took it down when there was a huge outcry because this man, of course, was found guilty in absentia of genocide.
By the way, I met him incidentally when I was there in Zimbabwe. He was in the president's office when I was there in the president's office. Then I met him and I talked to him. So that's what happened. In any case,
and you posted a comment saying, I wish to see more former heads of government and state in my country contributing their parts in different capacity after peaceful transition of political power.
No, that was not me. It is the officers there who did it, and I say this is wrong.
So you don't want Mr. Mengistu, with his conviction for genocide, to play a part in the new Ethiopia?
I think if we go through Truth and Reconciliation Commission, and if he's also given chance to, you know, to apologize, and then anything what the Truth and Reconciliation Commission brings into it, I think that needs, the country needs reconciliation. I have a deep belief that we need reconciliation. What matters is what's not the past, even the future. Is worrisome.
The past matters. The genocide isn't something
it
you
matters.
Just you
it
just
matters,
you just flick away and pretend
it
didn't happen. We have
to bring reconciliation to my country.
Explain to me, please, how a conviction for one of the most serious crimes on the planet would qualify Mr. Mengistu to contribute to the well-being of your country. How would a man with a qualification like that?
I think it depends on how the reconciliation
process goes. A
conviction
for genocide. A genocide. One of the most serious crimes you can commit.
Apartheid in South Africa has reconciled.
Apartheid isn't genocide, Mr. Hailemariam.
Yeah, for you,
it's not genocide.
But for Africans, it is more than genocide.
Where is your Truth and Reconciliation Commission?
It has been established, and we'll see the result. For you, yes, apartheid is not. But for us, it is.
So you're quite happy for convicted war criminals to come back to your country and play their part. Good old boys.
If the reconciliation procedure allows that, yes. If not, then no.
How should future generations in Africa protect themselves from people like you?
They should democratize their countries.
Get rid of dictators like you?
I think labeling me dictator is wrong. Is wrong. This is yours. It's not my people's. So I think this is misplacing again. This is rude from your side.
Hailemariam Desalegn, thank you very much for being on Conflict Zone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.